next thing we are discussing here is stability of stability of alkene. It depends on the number of hyperconjugative structure. Okay, more hyperconjugative structure, more will be the stability. So what we can say, stability is directly proportional to the number of alpha hydrogen. Stability is directly proportional to the number of alpha hydrogen. Okay, now this stability, that is stability due to hyperconjugation. Okay, if you compare stability due to hyperconjugation, just we calculate the number of alpha hydrogen, but for in a given molecule you can have all kind of effect possible. Okay, we can have resonance also. In a given molecule, resonance is also possible. We can have hyperconjugation is also possible, and we can have eye effect also possible. Okay, so when all these effects are there in the molecule, okay, or when there are more than one type of effect present in a molecule, then the stability will, you know, will define or will find out in this order. Resonance is the dominating effect here. Okay, so in the given molecule, if resonance, hyperconjugation both are possible, then resonance effect will be dominating. Or if two molecule, if you have to compare, one is showing hyperconjugation and other one is showing resonance, then the stability due to resonance will be more, that is because of hyperconjugation. Okay, and then we have eye effect. So eye effect is the least effect we have. Okay, and all these effects are dominated by aromaticity. Right, so aromatic effects is the most powerful effect, and that will dominate all other effect, resonance, hyperconjugation or inductive effect. Okay, so this you must keep in mind. Stability of alkene, if and only if hyperconjugation is possible, then we just calculate the number of alpha hydrogen. But in case of resonance, we'll have resonance is dominating effect. I effect, if it is there, then hyperconjugation will be the dominating effect. We'll see few examples on this, and then you will understand how to compare the stability of alkene when various electronic effects are there in the molecule. Okay, so we'll see some examples now. So all these questions are, we have to find out the stability order. Now you see all this example. First question, the number of alpha hydrogen here is 12. Number of alpha hydrogen is 9. Alpha hydrogen 6. Number of alpha hydrogen 3. Number of alpha hydrogen 0. Okay, so order of stability will be what? Most, only hyperconjugation possible, alpha hydrogen maximum, then this is the order. Okay, first, second, third, fourth and fifth, decreasing order it is. Okay, now this is the alpha position. Alpha hydrogen will be 8, and the alpha position here is this one and this one. So alpha hydrogen here it is 3. More alpha hydrogen, more will be the stability. Okay, I forgot to tell you here that hyperconjugation is possible in alkene as well as alkyne also. Okay, so there in the initial where I have written it, alkene, carbocation and free radical, they write down alkene or alkyne. In both hyperconjugation is possible. Okay, so number of alpha hydrogen here it is what? 3. Number of alpha hydrogen here it is 2. More alpha hydrogen, more hyperconjugative structure, more will be the stability. Number of alpha hydrogen 3, right? 3, 2, 5 and 2, 7. Number of alpha hydrogen 1. Stability order will be this. Number of alpha hydrogen 3 and 3, 6. Number of alpha hydrogen 2. Stability order is this. Okay, so like this we can compare the stability of alkene when only alpha hydrogen is, sorry, when only hyperconjugation is possible. Okay, few more example you see. OCS3, CH3. Okay, you see this one is aromatic compound and this one is anti-aromatic, right? Stability order is this. Okay, this one is oxygen has lone pair, so here we have resonance possible, right? And here we have hyperconjugation. Three alpha hydrogen, number of alpha hydrogen here it is what? 3. So resonance is more dominating, stability order is this. Okay, so like this we can compare the stability. Okay, so whenever you have alkene and only hyperconjugation is possible, just you calculate number of alpha hydrogen, more alpha hydrogen, more will be the stability. But when we have resonance and hyperconjugation, both are possible, then the resonance will be the dominating effect. Okay, according to that we'll define the stability. There are few examples in which the number of alpha hydrogen is same. Okay, so in that case what we'll do, okay, how do we assign the stability, that we are going to discuss now. Alpha hydrogen, for example, if I draw this, okay, so you see here the number of alpha hydrogen is 6, number of alpha hydrogen is 6, number of alpha hydrogen is 6. Okay, so in this case what happens, whenever the number of alpha hydrogen are same and only hyperconjugation is possible, then what we do, we'll draw the hyperconjugative structure. Okay, so for this one, if I write down the hyperconjugative structure, okay, so what happens, this sigma bond comes over here, pi bond will come here, right? And the hyperconjugative structure will be this CH2C single bond CH2 negative CH3, here we have H plus and double bond will have here. Okay, now in this, if I draw the hyperconjugative structure, that will be CH2H C double bond C CH3. So hyperconjugative structure it will be, and CH2H plus double bond CH double bond CH, sorry, CH3, here we have the negative sign. Okay, and in this case if you draw the structure CH2H, this sigma comes into pi and the structure here it will be CH2H plus double bond CH CH CH3. Okay, so now the point is, what is the difference in all these structure, right? What is the difference in all this structure? First of all, this carbon ion is 1 degree, we are getting carbon ion 1 degree, this is 2 degree and this is 2 degree. Okay, suppose this molecule is A, this is B and this is C. Okay, so molecule A gives 1 degree carbon ion. If you try to draw all the hyperconjugative structure, you will always get 1 degree carbon ion, but B and C gives you 2 degree carbon ion always. So obviously, since 1 degree carbon ion is more stable, right, so obviously molecule A is most stable over here, right? And in the second case what happens, since both we have 2 degree carbon ion and this one is trans, right, so 2 CH3 group is far away from each other in comparison to this one. Okay, so hence this one is more stable, less will be the hindrance, B is more stable than C. So order of stability will be A, B and C, right? Because in this B, second molecule, both methyl group are at the maximum distance, less will be the repulsion, and hence the order will be this. So if you have equal number of alpha hydrogen present, draw the hyperconjugative structure, compare the carbon ion. If it is 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, we know the order of carbon, order of stability of carbon ion. 1 degree is most stable, then 2 and then 3, right? So accordingly, we can write down the order of stability. If you have both 2 degree, then we can say that these two CH3 group is a transposition far away from each other, and hence less hindrance, more will be the stability, order will be AB and C. You can go through this.